In your biodata, you'll never feel I'm a body. It's taken for granted. I'm a male or female, you're feeling. Right? I'm a male body, okay. This is also biodata.
Conscious entity.
Huh. But are you conscious entity or are you your biodata? But how do you live your life as a biodata or conscious entity?
No, we live like a biodata and we die like a biodata. Entire life, nobody asks about the other side of it.
Other side of it. Okay. So there is something called I and there is something called biodata.
Inside and outside.
Biodata is very good to impress people. But don't fool yourself with your biodata. Okay? Biodata is very good. Fill up your biodata with nice things. Real or false. Doesn't matter. I'm not questioning that. I'm not even myth and truth. I'm not bringing them. Have your biodata. Make it nice. Make it look good. Okay? But my question is not about biodata at all. My question is about who is this guy who is having the biodata? Now you said, no, I'm a body and male body also, you said. Right? Okay, male body, you said. Are you clear? So let us look at this male body. How many people that you believe that you are a body and you are convinced that you are a body, please raise your hand. I am a body, I am a woman or I am a man. Okay, first I'll take ask man and I'll find out how many women also raise their hand. I'll find out. How many people believe that I am a man? Please raise your hands. Okay? No, woman is raised.
There's a man in every woman.
Okay? So actually, the Jhansi Ki Rani movie you would have seen, right? The Britishers wrote a report, British wrote a commentary on her, honorably. The only man in whole lot of revolutionaries is Jhansi Ki Rani Lakshmibai. So the man is not a body, the man is a quality. Okay, but let's take this as a body. So you are a man, you are a doctor, you have to be convinced that you are a body. Otherwise it's very difficult to come up right to the profession. So I am a body, correct? This is our conviction, this is how I live. So I am a body, is it an entry in your biodata or is it your reality?
Entering the biodata. Huh. Party.
I am a body, male or female is checked, right? Male or female. So you say, I am male. So you are checking, I am male body. Right? It's a biodata entry. And you start believing, I am a male body and start living your life. So you start believing your biodata. And biodata is only for the society. It's another society program. Right? So who are you really? So if you are a male body or a female body, okay, after death of the body has to be garlanded and kept in the house for next couple of years because you are the body, no? Somebody dies, right? He's a body, no? There's nobody has died because he's a body. So, keep the body in the house, every day feed some food and do namaskara, okay, because you are the body, no? No, you are saying I am the body, I am a male body or I am a female body. Let us say somebody dies, let us say a male person dies. He is the body, nothing has happened to him, no? Keep him in the house.
But he has died.
So he is not the body, he has died. He is something other than the body. Are you getting what I'm saying? He has, when somebody dies, you cannot keep the body half an hour, more than 3 hours. It will start rotting. So are you the body or are you something in the body?
Soul.
I am the soul in the body. But do you live as a soul or do you live as biodata?
Soul in the biodata.
Soul with the biodata is for practical purposes. But finally, what is your reality? Are you the real reality soul or biodata? See, the biodata is required for interactive society, right? When you are talking to a woman, you should become a man only, right? Otherwise, she will be confused, you are also confused. That's okay. That's for social interaction. But what are you really for yourself is the question.
So So the truth of the matter is, we live like a body and we are preoccupied most of the time with the body.
Body. So all your concerns and all with respect to your biodata are not about your self. The self is something which is using the body and at the time of death leaves the body and goes. So who are you? Are you the body or the self which is using the body? But then why are you leaving your biodata? Believe that you are biodata. Ask the question, how many of you say, I am the body, or all of you are raising? See, please understand, there is a social truth, social relationship is there, which is biodata. But what you are to yourself is what you are speaking of. Are you convinced in your heart of your hearts, I am not the body, but I use the body, are you convinced?
Yes.
Not. Doctor is not convinced.
I am not convinced, neither are my 90-year-old patient, because I am a geriatrician.
No. See, the purpose is not to convince anybody else.
No, that's the kind of, what I am trying to say is, in a general analysis, see, I have taken to Vedanta, this is my personal choice. But if I see the world unbiased, 99% they are living like as if...
No, here we are actually not changing the world.
But in general, we are the body only. And
no, this is what I'm saying. If you are saying, I am the body, okay?
What I'm trying to say is living like the body.
We are living like the body, but that's what I'm saying is coming from the social conditioning. So gradually we start deconditioning. So the question, deconditioning questions I'm taking one by one. Each of these is a prakriya. This is one prakriya. There are hundreds of prakriyas like this. Each of them will start looking at one aspect of your life and start questioning. So my question is, if you are the body, definitely your husband or wife should keep the body in the house after you are dead. Do they? 3 hours. When is the body going? Because what who was there within the body has already gone. What is the point? So the body is the vehicle and somebody using the body has already left. But all your life, you start believing that I am the body, it doesn't even come to your understanding that the body is the vehicle and I am using the vehicle, that mind doesn't come to it at all. Am I getting it? Huh? So, when I am talking to you, am I talking to the body or I am talking to the person, the consciousness is using the body?
Body is only an instrument.
But we live as a body is
the ultimate.
My friend means the body. My enemy means body. I am body. In fact, your friend or enemy has nothing to do with the body. Their bodies are vehicles.
Why does otherwise somebody kill somebody? Over enmity. Huh. Because he thinks the body wants to end.
That's something. The moment you say you are the body, some worldview will come with you. That will unless. First basic question is, I am the body. Premise is fundamentally wrong. It comes from social conditioning. Because we didn't deeply inquire why I am the body. I'm first trying to show one error in your mind. If you are the body, definitely keep the body of a wife or husband or somebody relative who has died in your house. Why you don't keep it? Because he's not the body. He has already left. Who is that left? That is the person. But while interacting, we think that body is the person and interacting. Can you understand the mistake which you are doing? It is like when you are talking over the mobile phone, right? So mobile phone, I am listening. So you ask, who's mobile? Hey, I am talking to my friend. Are you talking to your friend? Mobile phone is an instrument by which your friend is talking. So body is an instrument with which the consciousness is speaking. The mobile phone is visible, friend is not visible, friend is somewhere. The consciousness is not visible, the body is visible. We are mixing up visible with the invisible. Right? So which part are you? Are you visible part or invisible part?
Both.
If you are both, at least after death, body has to be kept, 50% of that is there, no? At least keep some leg or hand, no?
Only vehicle.
The vehicle is visible, the driver is not visible. Driver is invisible. The invisible driver comes and goes using the vehicle. But we don't even have understanding that the invisible driver is driving the visible vehicle. And we think that visible body is the
driver.
Is it an illusion or reality?
Right?
So, you look at any thought. You are actually living your biodata. In reality, you are not the biodata. You have a biodata, I agree. Is it clear? So, is this one program, first program that I am the body program, I have a question? Do you need any more convincing answer that you are not the body? Of course, I can give more program, more debugging programs to tell you why you are not the body.
When you have got problem in the body, that you would attend to the body.
When you have got a tire puncture of the car, should you repair the tire or not? Your vehicle, you will know, this vehicle, I don't repair it, you do that? I don't want to repair this. You have to clean the vehicle also, you have to maintain that also. You have to maintain the body, you have to maintain the vehicle. But the problem is not maintenance, the problem is mistaking yourself as the vehicle.
So the car is mine, but I am not the car.
Exactly. Car is mine also, you will have another assumption, okay, another program. So that will find out. See, these are all program within programs. Car is mine is a bigger program.
Bigger program.
We'll find out that.
No, what I mean is when you are affected in the body, it also affects the consciousness.
The consciousness doesn't affect because body is cut. Somebody meets with the accident. The consciousness, nothing has happened. It's left somewhere else. Please understand, anything happens, damage happens only to the visible. Invisible, nothing happens because it's invisible.
The body is affected, maybe the mind is affected. Not
consciousness cannot be affected.
Okay. Something is affected.
The mind. So what is that something, we'll find out. But find out first something you have to understand, there is a difference between what you are and what you have. Okay, let me take another example, okay? Can you please raise your right hand? Okay, so now, tell me what did you raise?
The right hand of your body.
So he said, right hand of my body. How many people agree with this? The statement is correct, factually correct?
My right hand.
My right hand is correct, factually correct? He said, my right hand I am raising. Is it correct or not?
Yes.
Correct or not?
Correct.
So my means, I have a right hand. My means something which I have and I am separate from what I am. So you don't say, if you are the body, you said, I raise my body, you should say. You said, my right hand. This means I have a right hand and that I raised. You didn't raise the body. Never comes to your mind that, oh, I am raising my body. I raised my right hand means I have a right hand which I am raising. I can raise what I have. For example, this duster is there, I can raise it. Okay. But I cannot raise what I am. What I am, I cannot do anything about it. It is already there. But what I have, I can do something about it. Oh, this mobile is there, this is there, I can use it. So you have two sentences. Please say, what is that? So this A and B, this is like come very crowd to the question. I am body and I have body. See, none of them. So A, B, C. I am body, I have body, none of them.
I have a body.
Let us take a voting, right? So how many people voted for A? How many people vote for A? Nobody. How many people vote for B? Keep your hand there. Sir, you voted for B, right?
I vote for C.
And anybody votes for C?
I vote for
See, none of them. Okay. So, many times I use the word, I am a body. Sometimes I use the word, I have a body. When do you use the word, I am a body, and when do you use the, I have the body?
When I have stomachache, I say,
I am a body.
Sir, you look very smart actually. How old are you?
40, mid-40s.
Don't look like it, sir. You look like a young boy just out of college.
Thank you.
So now you have become body. Right? So I start praising this person. He says, oh, I have the body. Already I have become body. Just now he chose the answer B.
Before the retreat, A was the answer. After the retreat, B.
B.
I'm sorry, I have a young body, sir.
I have a young body. So what happens is, in our talk and speech also, we actually unconsciously give the truth. So my leg is paining, you say. Somebody praises you, you look like smart. Huh? You already become the body. So you are actually, you have a, in your mind only, you are already confused. Sometimes you become the body, sometimes you have a body. My leg has a pain means I have a leg and that's paining. You look pretty good, I am the body. So which of this is true? I am the body is true, I have a body is true. Can't you make one choice in life? You can't. Why? You look very young, madam. You look so young. Alright? My body. So either you decide that I have a body or I am a body. But you yourself sometimes you say, I have a body, sometimes I am a body. Which of this is truth? Both cannot be true, no?
Meditation, you are doing, I don't have body.
That is C. We'll come to that. Right? Right now, nobody has dared to lift their hand for C. You lifted. Right? So, I am a body, I have a body. In our communication every day, we are confusing. Okay? If you say, I am the body, what is the problem for you? Is there a problem?
I can certainly perceive that I am more than the body because I can sense, I can...
Right. So, we have a way of looking at the world in different viewpoints, okay? First viewpoint, viewpoint one. View two. View three. So, I am body. So I am mind. I am intellect. View four. I am consciousness. There are four views in your life. Four views possible. The four way of approaching life from your point of view. The world point of view always say body. Right? World, we are not bothered with the world. From your point of view, you can take four viewpoints. First viewpoint is I am the body. Second viewpoint is I am the mind. The third viewpoint is I am the intellect. And fourth viewpoint is I am consciousness. So when you say I am the intellect, you are not a body actually. You are taking the I am the intellect point of view, you are taking. Right? Okay? So now, talk to your partner with the first. Say, I am body, okay? Then you say, tell to your partner, if I am body, how anything happens to the body, I am that. I am in pain, I am old. Whatever applies to the body applies to you, right? Are you getting what I'm saying? When you are the body, old woman, I'll just tell you one incident which really happened, then you'll proceed with this exercise. I purchased a house. I took for a house in rent in Malaysia. Okay. My earlier tenant had vacated the house and he had given the key to the owner, which is in the ground floor. He told me to collect the key from the owner. So I went to knock the door of the owner. The owner opened the door. One old lady, must be 80 plus, came out. I asked her, Ajji, key kodi, grandma, can you give the key? That lady burst out. how dare you call me grandma? I'll cut your tongue. Okay? How dare you call me grandma? In this whole street, nobody has the courage to call me grandma. Everybody calls me auntie. Since you are calling me, since you are the first time, you don't know, I am giving the key. Next time you call me grandma, you are out of the house before you know. Okay? So what happened? Why did she become angry? She has a concept that I am body. If she has a concept that I am not the body, then the anger will not come. Right? So now, that's true for I am the mind. If I am the mind, what will happen? I am happy. I am unhappy. I am happy with masala dosa. I am happy with my job.
I'm an angry person.
I'm an angry person. So, there's everything has a counterpart. I have a body has a counterpart, pain and pleasure. Pain and pleasure will come to you, packaged in. So mind, happiness, unhappiness will come to you. Like that, each of them has a plus and minus will come. Okay, so now, if you are consciousness, there is no plus and minus, right? Now, talk to your partner. First, tell about yourself as I am the body and tell about yourself. Then say, I am the mind and tell about yourself. Then I am the consciousness and tell about yourself. Okay, now, same thing you repeat. The other person, thinking that the other person is a body, other person is a mind, other person is consciousness, how will you interact with the other person? So, you have to do, first you start, and start talking to the other person as I am body, I am mind, I am intellect, and I am consciousness. Then I'll tell the second exercise. Are you clear?
Yeah.
So this is just to make sure that you understand what I am trying to tell. Go ahead, please. Madam, you look very beautiful. What is the secret of your beauty?
Yoga.
Ah, that's mind. You look beautiful. Must be using some special cream, the cream. I heard ice cream people apply their skin. So this is body consciousness, right? Okay, talk. Vani is a very wise person with the white hair. She is so wise. All radiating light only. That doesn't matter for us, right? The question is, what is your viewpoint of yourself? Okay? The entire spirituality is my viewpoint of myself, not about the world viewpoint of myself. So spirituality is shifting between the four viewpoints, You want you to win three, you fall. And depending on the situation, you may use any of them, but still you take your stand in one viewpoint, which is I am consciousness. So, for example, your wife is coming in front of you. The viewpoint is now what? I am the husband, not body. What do you think? I am not your husband, I am consciousness. That's not a viewpoint. That's the interaction viewpoint, is you have the body only. But deep inside, you know I am consciousness and I am using the body for interaction. That is the viewpoint. So I have a viewpoint of myself and I have a viewpoint for operating in the world. But my viewpoint of myself will never change. I am consciousness.
For communication purposes, I can use.
For communication purposes, use the different viewpoints. Just because you become spiritual, you can't say, no, 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 I am consciousness. This is not body, it's not me. You can't say that. Communication purpose, whatever the viewpoint world understands, use it. For example, tum sakar kal to hai. Did you understand anything?
No.
You didn't understand? I spoke in Konkani. For talking to you, I have to speak English only. I can only speak your language. My language you can't understand. I know I am consciousness, but when I speak to you, you look at me as a body, so I have to speak your language. So don't confuse these two views, my view of myself and my view of interaction with the world. My view of myself, gradually I have to move from biodata to reality. Are you getting what I'm saying? I am consciousness, my view has to become deeper and deeper as we do spiritual journey. But for interaction with the world, I am the body or mind or intellect, it will be same for the interaction. But even you interact also, you know that I am consciousness. Just like the doctor is interacting with her, he knows I am the husband of this lady. Okay? When you go to the patient comes, sir, can you check my heart rate? Yeah, I am husband of so and so checking the heart rate. It doesn't work, because patient has no relevance to that. So relevance is doctor only. So your viewpoint of husband as will remain, but in the background. Similarly, I am the Atma, I am consciousness is always in the background. Your interaction will be proper. That's what spirituality is. Is it clear or not clear?
Yes.
Huh? So after this class, everybody got very energized. So go home. What do you think? Husband comes. What do you think? I am the not the body, mind. I am Shivaswarupi. That husband will have a heart attack. For husband, your interaction is wife only. Don't confuse him. But for you are Atma. So spirituality is about not what we do with others. Spirituality is what I consider myself as.
But what you do with others also will get refined.
It will get refined, but that will not confuse them. Right? You may become more gentler or nice or simple, but you'll never confuse them. You don't go and say, I'm not the body, mind, I'm conscious. That guy thinks, oh my God, Vani has taken them to the resort or something has happened. So when you interact with the world, use the language which they can understand. But for you, don't use the language of the world for yourself. That's spirituality. Any questions? See, nijavada satyenu na helthane, repeat madi. The truth is nanu
nan
embudu
nan
alla
ideha
mana buddhi nan alla
Sachidanandatma
Shivanannane
Shivoham
Shivoham
Shivoham.
Idu nimmu matra kotha beri yari kotha. This you should only know. See what I said. I'll repeat. I am not the body.
I am not the body.
I am not the mind.
Not the mind.
I am not the intellect.
Not the intellect.
I am pure consciousness.
Pure consciousness.
Please understand this. You only should know. You should not even tell to somebody else. So next, tomorrow, I went to this reception, this class, no, this resort. Tomorrow, husband comes. Can you get me a cup of coffee? What do you think? I am not the body. I am not the. I am consciousness. Shivoham. Don't do such things. So this spirituality is only for about you to yourself.
Because I am Shiva, you should get me coffee.
You should get me coffee. So don't do such things. Okay? It is the spirituality is, please understand, is not to show off to somebody. It has nothing to do with show off, nothing to do about teaching anybody, nothing to do with telling anybody. Oh, here patient comes, sir, I have a stomach ache. What do you think you are show sorrowing?
Start telling.
Don't do such things. He is a patient, you are a doctor. All transactions will continue as it is. But your understanding of yourself gradually, internally has to change clearly to the reality. This is spirituality. The moment a person becomes spiritual, something starts coming. One big mala, one style, okay? And dress also changes.
Nama.
So spirituality, that's nothing to do with spirituality. It's all show. A spiritual person doesn't show anything. Deep inside he knows his Atma, and deep inside he knows everybody's Atma, but well, interaction he will do normal interaction. Are you clear? Because if you understand inside Shivam, nothing in the world damages you. Otherwise, everything in the world damages. Right? So this Shivoham is like an antibiotic which will prevent me from damage from the world. Spirituality is like an antibiotic. It's an antivirus which will help you to not to get damage from the world.
Bulletproof.
Don't even show to anybody. It has nothing to do with showing off to anybody. Nothing to do with teaching to anybody also. Okay? You have to ask the question, am I becoming more and more peaceful? Silent inside. Many people think spirituality, start thinking that, oh, I have to show this spiritual. Okay? So, some dress change, something happens. That's nothing to do with spirit. That they are related to religion. Religion is something. We are not speaking of the religion. We are speaking of the spirituality, which is your inner truth. Right? Okay, I'll give you another example to understand. A scientist is there, right? A scientist knows what is water. What is water? Please understand, tell me. H2O. Two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen. So he's thirsty. So he'll say, can you get me H2O? Okay, he doesn't do that. He says, give me water, because the other person only understands language. Another scientist may be H2O, he may bring it. But otherwise, person, his wife or something, what is H2O? She will come and pour one bucket of water on his head.
And even further, H2O is one molecule of water.
One molecule. Right? So now, please understand this. The absolute truth is I am consciousness, I am Brahman. But relative truth is I am the husband, I am wife, I am doctor. That's our role. Play that role well, but deep inside you know I am consciousness. Okay? Don't become your role for yourself. Don't cheat yourself. The biodata is always there for cheating somebody else. Please look at the biodata of anybody. Everybody, biodata is colored. Don't fool yourself with your biodata. That's all I'm trying to say. That's spirituality. Right? So now the same scientist, H2O, water he comes. So then here another cup of poison is there. Poison also, water is poison is added to water. This is H2O plus nitric acid. So I'll drink it. It's only water now. But he doesn't do that. No, gutter water is there, gutter water. That's also H2O, let me drink it. So the truth is there for you to understand about yourself and make your mind peaceful and live a peaceful life. That's spirituality. Not to cause confusion to others, not to change your dress outlook and make other people not to start converting. Conversion of other people is religion. It's nothing to do with spirituality. Spirituality is simply becoming peaceful. Am I making clear? So just now you went through one prakriya. Who am I? Okay, there are many such prakriyas, Vedanta. And each prakriya will bring out one aspect of you. So that's there's no time for us to do so many prakriyas here. So I gave an example of what prakriya is. Did I tell you are consciousness? believing that you are a consciousness? I asked you a simple question. If you are the body, after death keep the body in the house. Then you concluded, no, I'm not the body. I have something left the body. I didn't tell you that believe that you are conscious. I just give an example. Example. Oh, if you are the body, after death, the dead body should be kept in the house and at least in the fridge, no?
But Shankaracharya did that once.
For what?
For the time of
life. No, see, this is again a myth. See, this is again a social myth. See, Shankaracharya is Brahmadnani. He doesn't have to do prakaya pravesha. A Brahmadnani doesn't have body. So this actually some panditas had in between the story. Okay. So this, see, that's one thing. We have to be very careful what is myth and what is reality. A Shankaracharya is Brahmadnani who has understood, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. Why should he go into another body? There are so many misconceptions have come into our system. Okay, that we are taking it as reality and living our life. So we can't correct all those things. First we have to correct ourselves. Okay. So I didn't tell you, believe that you are a body. I asked you, you are the body. So fine, after death your body will be kept in the house. So that means you are not the body, somebody who has gone from the body. Then who are you? So this is called prakriya. It is not believing, it's logical way of understanding. Like that there are various logical way of understanding and breaking all the programs we have. That's called Vedanta. Okay?
We are not taking the keys.
Huh?
We are not taking back the keys.
So, let us give a big round of applause. Vani has delivered on a promise. One condition, Vani, 20% for me. Okay, so is there some 10 minutes we can sit silently? Or it's already time out? 150. So should we close or what is it? Oh, okay. So we'll stop, right? So just 5 minutes we'll do some simple meditation.
How this is linked to bliss here?
Which one? So how this is linked to bliss, right? If your viewpoint of life is I am body, so the I am in pain and I am in pleasure is a reality for you. So it means I am suffering, pain or pleasure. If I am the mind, then I am happy or I am unhappy is your reality. Okay? So if I am intelligence, I know something here, I forgot something, I don't know something, the knowledge and ignorance is your reality. If I am consciousness, like a child, who are you? Bliss. The bliss has no answer, no explanation. Right? So slowly, slowly, you have to move from one level of reality to other level of reality to finally settle down this reality internally, not externally. But internal settling down will have change your relationships, the way you relate and work. That's an effect of that. But this internal, but don't show to anybody, don't tell to anybody. Deep inside you start moving towards this reality without telling, without showing off. Deep inside, your reality about yourself should change. Then you start living in a state of bliss all the time. That requires breaking many programs. This is just one program. There are many programs. Each program has to be broken logically. We'll sit for some time silently.